I put my money where my mouth is, okay? I made a video on how I replaced all my Adobe apps with cheaper or free alternatives, and that's exactly what I did. But it seems like there's still a few non-believers. So in this video, I'm gonna show you how I made the thumbnail for this video in Affinity Photo 2. But also all of my older thumbnails that I made in Photoshop, like this one and this one. Well, you can easily make these in Affinity Photo 2 with the tools and techniques that I'm gonna show you in this video. Here we go. Okay, now the first thing you need, of course, is a background photo, which in this case is just an image of my studio background with the focus set here on my desk, because of course I want that nice blurry background. And that's it, that's the background. So let's open it in Affinity Photo. Then next we need some PNGs, right? The logos, the icons of the programs. Adobe, Affinity Photo, Photoshop, but also that explosion. Now the logos, just Google Adobe logo PNG and you'll find it. The explosion, well, two options. Or you can Google it and usually you'll find some free options, or just get it from a stock image website, up to you. And then just drop those PNGs on your background. Put them in the right position, super simple, right? And another thing you're gonna need for this thumbnail specifically is overlays. Now, what is an overlay exactly? Well, usually it's an image with a white or black background and you can use it to add texture, for example. So here I have an image of a crack, right? With white background. Well, if I place that on top of one of the icons and then set the blend mode here to multiply, the white background will disappear. And now it looks like the logo is cracked. Then just select both layers, right click, rasterize, then right click again and merge selected. And now it merges both layers into one, which makes it easier to work with. And if your overlay has a black background, like this one for example, well, then all you have to do is set the blend mode to screen to make the black background disappear. And again, you can find free options, free overlays on Google, or pay a stock image website. Okay, so now we have all the elements, but it looks a bit boring and too static. So let's add some motion blur to make it look like a real explosion, like there's some movement. First, for the logos, the icons, just select the layer with the logo, go to filters, blur, and motion blur. Then set the intensity and the angle, and you're done. But the problem is now that it applied motion blur to the entire icon, and I don't really like that. It makes the icon, I don't know, disappear in the background, and that's not what I want. So let's undo that blur, and now I'm going to only blur the bottom part of the icon. So go to the selection tool here, select the freehand selection tool, set the feather to, let's say 100 to make the selection softer, and then just make a selection of the bottom part of the icon. And if you click on this icon right here, you can check what your selection looks like. See? And that looks okay. Then make sure that the layer with the icon is selected, go to filter again and apply some motion blur, just like before. And there you go. And then for the explosion, I'm gonna use a different kind of motion blur because it has to go in all directions. So let me make these layers invisible here so you can see everything a bit better. There. Now, here I want only the edges of the explosion blurred, right? So again, with the freehand selection tool and the feather set to maybe a bit more now, let's say 300, make a selection. But then before we apply the blur, we have to invert the selection because, like I said, I only want the edges of the explosion blurred. So invert it with the invert button right here. And then just like before, again, filters, blur, but now we're gonna pick the zoom blur. Set the intensity, and if you click on the image now, you can set the center of that zoom blur, see? But of course, I want the center of the blur to be right in the middle of the explosion here. And that's it. Looks really cool. And of course, you can experiment with other filters too. The more you use them, the more you'll learn. And then the final step is masking, one of the most important things you should learn. So I want it to look like the Affinity logo is in the middle of the explosion. I want some smoke in front of the logo to make it look more 3D. You know what I mean? So select the layer with the Affinity logo and then hit this icon to create a mask. You'll see this white square icon appear here next to the layer icon. And then with that white square selected, that's the mask, start painting with the paintbrush set to black to make parts of the logo disappear. See? And of course, you can play around with the size and hardness of the brush. And if you switch to white and paint over the logo, you can make those disappeared areas appear again. So it's like a non-destructive eraser. And here in the mask icon, you can also see where you've painted black and white. And if there's a layer underneath, of course you'll see that layer. In this case, the explosion. And then, yeah, you can make it look like the smoke of the explosion goes in front of the logo. But always make sure that you have the mask icon here selected. If you select the layer icon next to it, you'll just paint white or black on the image, and you're not masking. And then all we have to do is add some text, and we're done. That's how I create most of my thumbnails. And you know, Photoshop, Affinity Photo, it doesn't matter. The workflow, the process is exactly the same. There you go. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.